Welcome back. This is Blue, and this is the new update. Don't know what all's going on, but this seems to be a new system that Polo sends you to find some rare ass shit. We appear today to have a room full of people. 15 in the same game. Everybody say what's up. What's up? Crazy new network and voice fucking options to go through. It's about time, now that I can actually change permissions and such. Don't worry, guys. It's anyone all the time. So let's get into this. This obviously is an abandoned station. It's an abandoned system. Apparently this is where you make Quicksilver now, so let's go see what everybody's doing. Two games. phase of the galaxy, eh? Well, apparently it's going to be an eight week little project they're doing here. We are in week one of eight. Everybody's found everything except this one animal. And I found it! Ah ha ha! Uploaded. Hey, what's up, man? I'm alright. Just broadcasting this new stuff. What's going down? You just been bumping into them silent bobs around the world. It's alright. Quicksilver is what I'm guessing, because that's what it said on the portal. S-class scanner, huh? That ain't no joke. See, that's like Polo. He be offering motherfuckers $2 million items and shit, and then when you buy it, it's a Class C fucking upgrade. It's like, what the fuck? Polo, you supposed to be my boy! I'm gonna go ahead and put this on right now. Let's go ahead and take the range up a little, see what we get. Jesus, my scanner range is up to 1533.1. That is ridiculous. I wonder when they're gonna fix this animal thing, is my deal. I scan an animal and I name it based on its look, and then when I go back, it ain't there. It's some new animal with the name that I named. Little things here and there, I guess. What is this? Cobalt, huh? You know, nobody got him yet. Damn, you only get one chance a week to do this, apparently, because the timer is sitting at 6 days, 43 minutes, 5 seconds. This is the most people I've seen in the same game ever, dude, by the way. It was 15 when I signed into this, or I should say it was 15 when I jumped into the portal. It might have been what they fixed. From what I heard through the grapevine, you know, the whole game, like, underground, they were supposed to be fixing the duplication glitch and making it easier for a lot of people to get in on the same server. Yeah. But apparently they have done this multiplayer glitch up right this time. Like I said, it was 15 when I checked a while ago. Let's see. There's a room full of 16 players, 4 teams. What color is your icon, man? What color is the icon that you see? Like when you look at other players? I guess, sir. No, I see. Yeah, I see. Bankin' Noiser. He's like a green tag where everybody else is a white tag. Man, I found this thing. I've been looking for it since I fucking found it. Some homeboy could get it. And I'm gonna tell you something. It's hard as fuck to find those. Scan for these underground shits, man. I don't see nothing, dude. Not one fucking thing. Okay, that's a big ugly guy. Obviously these game producers watch my videos, man, because they fix everything I do. Oh, splash. I'm surprised there aren't more monuments around, you know. Considering there's so many. The way it works is you approach another character when the only thing you can see is like that blue orb, right? You both press square. I'm pretty sure you can't do it in a star base, but anywhere else, it'll make a monument. And I think it's per system. I'm not real sure how it works. Me and my friend, my online game friend, he's like, he was like, well, let's do this. So we did it. And like I said, it made a fucking a monument. And for some reason, that monument disappeared. I guess only other people can see it. But someone made a monument right outside the portal here. And I can actually, like, see someone else's monument now. So maybe they fixed all that. Yeah, see? Nothing on the dig scanner. Oh, what is that? That's paraffin. Yeah, see? All I'm reading are deposits. Nobody has scanned these shits yet. I mean, really? Yeah, I'm naming that one. Let's see. Apparently, it's, there's shit everywhere left to scan. I've got, what, like four animals so far. About three trees. Yeah, most of the plants have been scanned already. Let me take that back. All of them have been scanned already. I'm renaming the last one right now. Yeah, and the checkpoints too. It's like 31 waypoints discovered. Really? Jesus. Yeah, man, a lot of people don't go in the water or in a cave. Like, shit, I'm not making a base there unless there's cave and a water. That's the easiest place to find cobalt underground. The blue striped oak is official. I remember when I first started playing this, man, I came across a galaxy somebody, or I should say a system somebody named the Girl Zone 3. And of course, the first planet you see in that is, it was named Stinky Finger Planet. Yeah, man, it's ridiculous. It's like, man, it had to be a 12-year-old. If not, it's a 30-year-old who thinks he's a 12-year-old. Stinky Finger Planet. It's ridiculous. It was adequately named, because it, laughably enough, it was one of those planets where it has the huge, like, plateaus that are just giant cylinders sticking out of the ground. So, I mean, it was appropriately named, but still. So, what do you think about this fucking crazy ass algebraic fucking calculus fucking shit you're supposed to know just to play this game? Cash do you got, bro? It don't matter. Just come find me. I'll chunk some cash at you, and we'll make a monument on this cliff top. Damn, it's right by our deposit. What do we got here? Oh, some cobalt. That's a pretty good size deposit, though. I don't know, they might have turned off giving items to people too. Who knows? Like, y'all are fucking our game up. Like, I ain't fucking up shit. Call my ship in. Let's put it down. I think I got it at like 1.3 or something, and man, the shift between then and now, it's 1,000 times better. before it was just like sticks sticking out of the ground and rocks, you know, there wasn't no plants nowhere, grass. The clouds look like shit, you know, really. But now, man, the biomes are actually like lifelike. They still ain't got to where you can scan every plant and like every little rock everywhere, but man, they're coming along and pretty quick too. Like I said, when I first started playing this, it was just sticks in the ground. There literally wasn't leaves on trees, there wasn't no blades of grass. The clouds were just like, I don't know how to explain them. You couldn't see through them. There was no transparency, so, you know, once you got in one, that was it. Man, for all those grind forever games out there, this one's a little different. And I have to say I like it myself, man. It's good stuff. I got five types of shields and they're all empty. Couldn't make a base a while ago, let's see. Yeah, you can't base this planet. So, yeah. They're making it to where you can't come back here at all. And what is the deal with this save point? I made a save point last night. Made a hard save. Jumped in my ship. Did my soft save. And still, every time I make a save, it just vanishes into the universe, man. It's like some black hole is sucking all this shit out of there. Work on the save points. Let's go ahead and dump this one. I should get some plating somewhere from it. Wow. You're just gonna steal my plating like that. That's awesome. Fuck. Let's go find some more ferrite. So, you been into any of the tripped out planets yet? Like a synthetic or a blighted world? And by blight, I don't mean the toxic ones. I mean the ones that are fucked up, like giant columns everywhere. Bubbles, man. I found like 7 bubble planets. Aw, man, you're in for a good treat then. Once you start getting into the blighted places or the abandons, there'll be a lot of fucked up looking planets around. I found one with stellar corruption. I named it Darkness Falls if you ever come across it. It's a tripped out place. Yep. The green bubble. Like they changed the jetpack ratios too, because man, that took half a jetpack to fly 100 feet. Yesterday I was flying fuck half a mile up. Yeah, I don't know. Like I said, that's the money maker, as far as I know. Once you get your scanner right, hell, animals make you the most money. It says there's 4 more. Yeah, it's dark outside. We're on the nighttime. All right, now just press square and it should make a monument. Oh, okay. There is already a monument in this system. Well, fine then. They're down to one monument per system? What the fuck? Let's see, can I even teleport anything? Yeah, these are worth a chunk. Oh, wow. Nothing. I guess we gotta know each other before I can give you an item. I'll tell you what. Yeah, it's the way it was supposed to work from the beginning, I think. When two players meet, you know, you make a monument, and then you become, like, allies, right? And once you make the monument, you can trade items and stuff like that. But there ain't no telling what they did to it. It was a 2.5 gig update, man. They could have changed at least a third of the code with that shit. See, we should be able to make a monument any fucking where, but somebody made one down there at the portal, so I guess we can't. And like I said, I can't move an item or nothing. Hey, they changed the way the walker brain looks. That's weird. I'll tell you what, I'll just look at you through the system menu. Alright, you said wiggle, right? Alright. Wiggle Van Stickle? Alright. I'm gonna send you a request, man. See what happens. Hey, what's up, Danny? There's some tea in the icebox. I'm waiting on the dude to fix the Coke machine. He said 20 minutes. I figured I'd give him a little longer. Glasses are right here, Pops. And then, tea's in there. It's been in there a couple days. It should still be good, though. I got that request out. I don't know what's gonna happen though. It was being a little choppy, the menu. But, like I say, if nothing, man, we'll jump in on our own game, or I'll jump in on yours or something like that. We'll make a monument somewhere. Guess where we can trade up and stuff. It's kinda weak, you don't have one monument per system. Thank you. nice if you could read these communication beacons before you have to, like, get 2 feet from them. Designated 420 zone. Really? Really? Man. They're gonna have to let people destroy this shit, I'm just saying. That was like, trying to find a decent weapon. You know, I busted open the portal and started using the Stargate. And man, I got to that planet and couldn't do shit. Because there's like 5,000 communication beacons there. You can't target nothing. You can't use your pulse engine because it just focuses you away from the planet and puts you out in space somewhere. It's crazy. Say touch plants with touch plants that don't risk, really? Seriously, I have nothing here but like salvage tech and another plant. Really? I guess it'd be easy place to find, like zoology. Well, see, that's what I'm saying. I think it's first come, first serve. It's like, it'd have to be because I've scoured this planet for about, 20 minutes now and nothing. Where'd you find it? Like, what was the area like? Mountainous, it was a flat spot, you were in the water, but that's what I figured out. My bad. That's what I figured. I'm trying to get away from all the damn communication beacons and start looking. Thank you. and say, what do you need? But it seems like can't nobody communicate or trade or anything on here. What's up? Mine should be anyone. Let's see. Ah, okay. I got you. See nothing. Literally nothing. No deposits. Nothing. Jeez. To another planet and see what's up, because this one seems to be burnt up. Like the Stargate portal. is a badass exotic, just search lipstick, and you'll get the chance for a badass UV as more experiments. I gotta experiment with 100% scanner range. Thought y'all guys was bad, they said you're not neat. Save and reload, because like I said, every planet, same thing, no scanner data anywhere. I think all you gotta do is claim it, right? And it'll just spawn in and you fix it from there. Hey, yeah, see, I didn't know about that. I would always find a badass ship, fix the thrusters, and trade it off for something better. Ships, they're gonna be like 48-8 and shit. I tell you what, if every slot or every other slot in it's busted up, just throw that piece of shit away. It'll cost you like $10 million just to fix it. I was like, damn. Sounds like a GTA game to me, $10 million a ship. I've actually been blessed so far. I have 6 exotic ships. If you can call that blessed, that's a lot of money, is what the hell it is. Like 10 million a ship. What is it, one of them is Okuni of Death, the other one is Ultimate Song, there's another one I picked up, The Mistress of Destiny. What's that one? Reichi Defender. Tranquil Sleep. That's what's up. Oh, you got a Tranquil Sleep, man. Fuck. See, I picked one of those up in my creative, but I ain't been able to find one here. Still sitting on level zero. And technically, to me, the way it should work, you know, yeah, that's what I'm saying. I've scanned it all on a bunch of types of planets, like a full life planet where it's copious, and what else was it? The two super words for what kind of or how much life is on a planet, it's copious fauna and something else. But even doing a low life planet or a no life planet, I should get credit for that shit. It ain't my fault there ain't no life on that planet. Well, even then, you're still scanning fauna on those low atmosphere planets. It's those five plants that are on every planet: the booster, oxygen, sodium, and what are the other two? Shit. But even then, what I'm saying is there's still three or four plants, you know what I mean? Even in a low oxygen environment, there's still shit you can scan that's alive. It should count, you know? Well, see, that's my thing. It's what I was saying to old boy a while ago, Wiggles, I mean. I'll scan a life form and name it based on the way it looks. And when I come back, it's like the only thing it'll show is like the face of it and the tail or something like that. Or like I named one Horned Dragon, you know, because it was like this dragon walking around, fucking big horns all over it and shit. Looked kind of like a dinosaur with like a cougar's face, you know. I named it Horned Dragon, uploaded it and all that, came back. And it's, now it's something different. It's like a lizard with a Venus flytrap for a mouth. So it's kind of weird the way that random code generation works. It's like I figured if I named it and uploaded it, at least it would stay the same, you know, but there's no consistency in it yet. Y'all should probably check that out. None of it? Man. Fuck is with my game, man. Let me look. Well, see, when I look at someone else's discoveries, it like shows the whole animal. This is a bunch of little cutesy stuff here. I don't know. There's one left. But if I look at my own discoveries, the plants usually look fucked up. Or not the plants, but the fauna. Let's see. Let's find one. No. Those are blights. Fuel stuff. I hadn't checked it since the new patch, so might as well upload you. Yeah, it's like two plants here with no pictures at all. Let's see, check the animal list. Oh, that's a fungal planet. It's all like bouncing pineapples and shit. Let's go for Hanimal. What was it? New Waymont? Yeah, New Waymont. It didn't used to be that way, did it? Because when I first started playing, it was like it would crash out because there were so many freighters in. It's like if you got more than two people's freighters in the same area, it'd fucking crash your game. I'm thinking that's what they did to solve the problem for now. But like I said, me and my friend Magic, when we first started playing, you could spawn at least two in. You had to be all the way across the system from each other, you know, because the area consumption space, that bubble, man, it was huge. Oh, let's see. You mean like the shield mod, or you mean... Oh, yeah, man. I found that one right off. The one I had trouble with was fire, actually, and toxicity. Oh, shit. That's a new-looking thing right there. Okay. A six-legged monkey with a pink tail. Okay, my bad. It's a six-legged warthog with a tail. What's up, man?